This is a guide for long sword, mouse and keyboard. Right off the bat, what you are realizing here is I have at the bottom left control or the left control. If you don't have that as your key binding, that means you have the middle mouse button. So this guide is gonna be for the two kind of players, the people who have the default setting like myself or doesn't have the default setting like myself, I don't know, one out of the other, who have the left control as their spirit gauge, spirit blade attack, or the people who have it as the middle mouse button. So I don't want you to go to the comment section below and tell me, hey, your key binding is different than mine. No, I am explaining it for everybody here. Focus with me. Let's get started. First of all, let's start with the basic attack. Left click is gonna unseathe your weapon. Can you unseathe the weapon with the right click? You cannot. Can you unseathe the weapon using the control? Yes, you can. And if you cannot do it with the control and it will pull out your shortcut, that means it is your middle mouse button. Left click, again, unseat the weapon. Left click, step slash. Heavy attack, slow, high damage. Right click, thrust attack. Fast attack, low damage. Let's do a combination here real quick, which is right click, left click, rising slash. So far, so good. This is the basic combo, nothing too complicated. Now, when we attack, you can see at the top left here, you don't see it here because of the thing, but see where is the mouse? Focus with it. Now, you see this. This is the sword icon, and you see there is a red gauge in it. When the red gauge at 75%, we can go to the next level of our sword, which gonna give us more damage. Now, how do we get to the next level? We do the normal combos. See, it is increasing. Now we have it 75% or 100%. Now we go for the most basic thing here, which is left control or middle mouse button. We just need to spam the whole thing till we reach this attack. Spirit round slash. Now it is on white, which means that we have extra damage. How many levels do we have? We have three levels. Second level is yellow. Third level is definitely red. One more attack also is when we press both right click and left click, which will give us this attack. And now we can go for our combo, spamming left control or spamming middle mouse button based on your key binding is gonna give you the next level. Keep in mind that this combo, the most important thing in this combo is the last hit. Let's go again for the max level. So, we are doing the full combo, we're not hitting any of it except the last one. Now we get the next level. Let's say that you did the combo and you hit all your hits except the last one. Are you gonna get the next level? No, you're not gonna get the next level. This is the most important hit. This one. Connects, you get the next level. Doesn't connect, you don't get the next level. One way to get your level to sword to the next level in order for you to gain more damage. How many ways can we get the sword to the next level? There is three ways that I know of. This is the first one. The second one is sliding, double control, and this need to connect. If this one connects, you get the next level. What happens if I am at the max level? My level is gonna reset. As you can see, it is slowly decreasing. When it reaches the end, what happened? As it will go to the previous level. Let's show it one more time. This is it. Connects. Now it is reset. Now, what did we go over? Heavy attack, short attack, short attack combination with the heavy attack. Right click and left click together is gonna give us this hit, will make us move a little bit backward in order for us to reposition ourselves for the monster. If you want to reposition yourself a little bit to the back. Now the most important skill or the most stylish skill is the Helm Breaker. The Helm Breaker. How can we perform the Helm Breaker? Left control, left click, or middle mouse button and left click. Again, based on your key binding. Let's show it here real quick. This is it. We're dealing good damage here. This is at level 3. Now, after we use this attack, what happened is our sword became level 2. That means we are doing less damage. Let's see, that was 190 something. And now it's 106. And now it went also to the previous level. Keep in mind, if you don't have any level at your sword, it's not gonna perform this attack. In the case of this attack, you can aim it wherever you want while you are jumping. Now we're done with this one. Let's go for the special seed. The special seed is used after every attack except the claw attack. So we do any attack, we do left control and space, take us to the special seed. If it's not left control and space in your key binding, it should definitely be middle mouse button and space in your key binding. Two kind of attacks we can do from this one. The first attack is the I slash using the left mouse button on everybody, which is this one. This one can be used to dodge monster attack. You need to time it perfectly. Now you're gonna ask me, what is the perfect timing for it? I don't know. You're just gonna have to develop a feel for it. And if you know, tell me so I can learn also. The other, and one important thing. When I do this attack, what will happen is my sword is gonna be glowing. What does that mean? That means the spirit gauge is automatically refilling even without me attacking. So this is a good thing to have in mind. The other one is the I spirit slash, which is this one. Using left control or using the middle mouse button. So we go for left control space or middle mouse button space. Then we go for the left control or middle mouse button. We'll do this attack. This attack also dodges monster attack. Give you a few second, give you a second or like few milliseconds of invulnerability. And it will consume a spirit level, or like, I don't know what do you call it. Let's call it sword level for this guide, okay? It will consume a sword level unless you get a successful dodge with it. And you will hear the tring. How about I show you an example? Let's see it.
Come on,
this is a good one, guys. This is a good one. He definitely have a nice weekend. In the case of this attack, it will not consume any spirit level or any sword level from you, but it will keep your sword glowing and also can be used to dodge attacks. Now, something really important here is the foresight slash. Foresight slash is a really important skill to have on the long sword. And after every attack, you cannot do it as the first attack. It needs to be the second attack. Let's go for the thrust attack. Then we do left control and right mouse button. Again, if it's not left control and middle mouse, and it's not left control on your key binding, it will be middle mouse button and right click. So there is two kind of key binding we agreed on right now. This is what we're gonna be doing. Attack, foresight slash, left control, right mouse button, or middle mouse button and right click. Kind of messed it up a little bit, right? Again. Left control, right mouse button, or middle mouse button and right control. Right? This is the foresight slash. What is the follow-up to the foresight slash? Or let's talk about it a little bit here. Foresight slash, first of all, you need to have a spirit gauge. This red thing on the top left need to be full 50%, 45% in order for you to get a successful hit. What happens if it's empty? If it's empty, the successful dodge will not occur, resulting in you getting hit by the monster. We go for it. Then he will do this attack. This attack need to connect the second attack. After this attack connects, you press left control or you press middle mouse button in order for you to get the next level. Finally, let's talk a little bit about the Helm Breaker. Helm Breaker, we agreed, it's not going to happen unless you have at least one level. So now we have a one level. We're gonna go for the Helm Breaker. This is our Helm Breaker. It connects. After the Helm Breaker, we can go definitely for the Special Seed. Or, what can we do is not go for the Special Seed. So this is based on your situation, based on your understanding of the game. You're gonna make the decision. You're gonna make a lot of mistakes first if you are new to the weapon. We can roll, right? Or we can continue the normal combo. Definitely, if you are new to the weapon, you're gonna make mistakes, but error and trial. So you make the mistake, then you're gonna learn from it and see what is the best situation for you personally. To go for a special seed or just roll away from the monster or just go for a normal attack based, again, on your understanding. Now we have zero level. We go Helm Breaker. Definitely nothing happens. We need at least one level. One more attack to show you here real quick. Slide, jump, left click. Jumping slash. This is the last attack I'm gonna show you. So this should be it for the long sword, mouse and keyboard. I hope you found this video helpful. Like the video if you liked it. Also subscribe if you like to see more. I stream almost every day. I stream a lot of Monster Hunter World. I do a variety of game also. So check out the Twitch in the description below. Also check the Instagram. We have good clips. And now what I'm going to be showing you is some dodges that we talked about. So we already saw this one. This is the special seed into the Ice Pirate Slash.
Come on, let's go every day. Including what? Including Sunday.
Nice one. Now, this is the... We're gonna be seeing here the dodge with this attack. Where is the attack? Show me attack. With this attack. And now we're gonna see Foresight Slash. This attack need to connect. Then we go left control or middle mouse button based on our key minding. It's been a pleasure, everyone. I don't know how to do anything. See ya.